And my dear friends, remember, due to bleeding as external as internal bleeding in our organism is formed the final difficult complication, and without medical help, due to this complication, victim is died. This acute post-hemorrhagic anemia. Next, shock, primary and secondary shock. Primary shock causes reflex cardiac arrest and death in case of injuries of so-called shockogenic zone. And my dear friends, secondary is traumatic shock. And remember, my dear friends, first clinical symptoms of traumatic shock, clinical symptoms, skin are pale, adynamia, passive position of the body, areflexia, reflex very quickly go down, decreased, areflexia. But you can see clinical sign of tachycardia, pulse more than 100 beat in per minute. Next, arterial pressure very quickly go down, decrease. In this situation, without medical help, patient is died, victim is died. And if take massive and acute bleeding, internal, external bleeding, is formed the first acute post-hemorrhagic anemia and maybe hypovolemic shock. Next, different types of embolism, as air embolism, pneumothorax, fat embolism, thromboembolism, and the other. Blood aspiration due to trauma of the lung, due to pulmonary bleeding, blood aspiration, and the hematothorax. Due to pulmonary bleeding, blood go as into respiratory tracts and blockade closed respiratory tracts, and the tamponade of lung. If blood go into cavity, is formed hematothorax. Next, contusion of the heart with reflex cardiac arrest. Next, contusion of the brain with different type of hematoma, as under pia mater, under dura mater, and the hemorrhage into stem and other hemorrhages. So this primary causes of death, probable causes of death. Secondary, in most cases, the secondary complication, which is formed due to primary complication. We look, acute kidney insufficiency, which is formed due to traumatic shock. Look, due to traumatic shock, victim is died, maybe due to kidney insufficiency, due to cardiac insufficiency. Next, acute blood loss and massive crush on the soft tissue. Kidney insufficiency due to DIC syndrome. Traumatic toxicosis, thromboembolism, sepsis, inflammation of the brain and its membranes. And there are, as a final, this pneumonia, maybe is formed pneumonia. The secondary causes of death. Next, in our topic, I give you, my dear friends, very, very short classification of firearms with main groups. Now, in first group, look on this slide, you can see next type of firearm, battle, hunting, sports, and the special. Battle, this automatic device, this semi-automatic device as a pistols. Hunting firearm with one, two, or few barrels, sports firearm, and the special. Second group, according to the mechanism of a shot. Firearm can be to if take mechanism for short, automatic, semi-automatic, and non-automatic. Now, as an example, automatic are very nice firearm in all world, in all country. This automat Kalashnikov 47, AK-47. This battle firearm, automatic firearm with medium caliber and medium barrel and the rifle battle firearm. Next, second photo, the semi-automatic firearm. In Ukraine, this pistol named Makarov, this pistol have a policeman, military specialist, and this firearm with large caliber, more than 9 millimeters. This semi-automatic firearm, and I repeat, this battle firearm. Next, hunting firearm. In most cases, this non-automatic firearm. On this slide, you can see firearm with two barrels. And in most cases, hunting firearm have a long barrel and a smooth barrel. Next, if take battle cartridge. For battle firearm. Look, in this situation, you can see few structural components. A cartridge case with yellow color, cartridge case, metallic case. In base of this case, present primer. In primer, present specific substance. Next, in case like it, gunpowder. And look, this case hermetic closed, bullet, only one bullet. As a result, due to one shot, one battle cartridge into body, you can see one entrance wound, one wound canal, which penetrate into body, and one exit wound. Or one bullet which navigate into body without exit wound. Because in cartridge, battle cartridge, present only one bullet. So look, hunting cartridge have case with cylindrical form, battle as a cuneiform. Next, in base as in battle present primer. Next, gunpowder, and the next specific structure. What? Look, like it between gunpowder and the shot. And look into hunting cartridge, present very many small dense highlights, shots, many. As a result, due to one shot, with but a hunting cartridge. Into body is formed one entrance wound with large size, with irregular edges, and into body is formed numerous wound canals with small diameter. And in different organs and in soft tissue, you can see a shot, many shots. And the hunting cartridge closed gasket. So repeat, battle cartridge, structural components, cartridge case, primer, gunpowder, one bullet. Structure hunting cartridge, cylindrical case, primer, gunpowder, wad, next shot, and the closed gasket. Next, continue work with our classification. If take internal surface of barrel of a different firearm, if take battle firearm, in most cases, internal surface rifle. As an example, automat Kalashnikov rifle. smooth barrel, in most cases hunting firearm, and they combine, maybe hunting, maybe sports. Look, internal surface of a barrel, smooth, rifled, combined. One part smooth, other rifled. Next, group in our classification. Caliber of our firearm or diameter. Caliber or diameter. Internal diameter of barrel. If take rifle firearm, a small caliber.
Yeah?
What do you want?
So, do you have any questions?
Don't answer the mic.
No, ma'am.
No, good. Small caliber, 4 to 6 millimeters. Medium caliber, 7 to 9 millimeters. And large caliber, more than 9 millimeters. If take AK-47, this battle automatic rifle firearm with medium caliber. If take pistols, Tete, Makarov, Stechkin, this semi-automatic battle firearm with large caliber, more than 9 millimeters. So this slide, I show, draw a diagram and the theoretical information with mechanism of a shot. Look, you can see into barrel, in cavity of barrel firearm, you can see battle cartridge. And look, a strike bar primer, as part is formed. Is formed because into primer present specific substance which gives spark. Next, a spark ignites the gunpowder. Gunpowder is burns and is formed due to burns of gunpowder, is formed powder gases and soot. Soot, this black, the substance with a black color, which is formed due to burns of gunpowder at shot. Next, powder gases, squeeze bullet outside. And look, my dear friends, with bullet, go outside as fire, as powder gases, as soot, as gunpowder, and the small metallic particles and drops of oils which locate in internal surface of barrel. These components which go with bullet from outside, name a components of a shot. Fire, powder gas, soot, gunpowder, small metallic particles, and drops of oils, this accompanying components of a shot, which is formed in moment of shot. So next, look, you can see bullet and the accompanying components of a shot. Fire, powder gases, soot, and the small gunpowder and small metallic particles and drops of oils, accompanying components of a shot. Now, look, you can see a mechanism shot in case of this hunting firearm. You can see internal surface of barrel, canal of barrel, smooth surface. And strike a primer with a spark is formed. Spark ignites gunpowder. Gunpowder is burns. Powder gases squeezed is formed soot. Squeezed water with shot from outside. So this result shot of hunting firearm. This contact. Contact shot, because look, you can see Stanzmark. I give you this information with characteristic of and definition Stanzmark in next slide. Next, close shot. Look, you can see in soft tissue, you can see very many, and in wound canal, very many shots, look, which penetrate into skin and into soft tissue and into body. Next. Look, you can see large entrance defect with irregular form, irregular edges, but in this situation, around of this wound, like it, many small entrance wounds. In this situation, shot was of long distance shot. And look, you can see very many small entrance wound without a large entrance wound. In this situation, shot was on the very long distance. Next, my dear friends, attention, difficult information. Types of action of a bullet. In case with gunshot injury, distinguished four types action of a bullet. By kinetic energy, if take kinetic energy. Explosive action, bullet kinetic energy over 1,000 joules. Penetrating action of a bullet, kinetic energy between 100 less 1,000 joules. Cuneiform action of a bullet, kinetic energy over 10 less 100 joules. And the contusion action of a bullet, kinetic energy very small, less 10 joules. And my dear friends, as explosive, as a penetrative action of a bullet, in this situation, bullet have very large kinetic energy and very difficult traumatic action. In medical practice and in forensic medical practice, we have contact with a victim with gunshot injury, which is formed due to cuneiform action of a bullet. In this situation, kinetic energy, I repeat, over 10 joules, but less 100 joules. And the contusion action, less 10 joules. So specific morphological sign for explosive action of a bullet with very large kinetic energy, very large force. Look, you can see deformation of the part of the body and the destroyed defect into as a skin, as a soft tissue, as a bone tissue. Look, you can see very large defect with irregular form into different tissues with deformation part of the body. This may be head, maybe thorax, maybe abdominal cavity, and maybe is formed amputation fingers, amputation legs due to this action. So I repeat, specific morphological sign for explosive action of a bullet, kinetic energy over 100 joules, this large defect in different tissue with deformation part of the body. Next, penetrative action. In this situation, kinetic energy over 100, but less 1,000 joules. Into body is formed large defect, but without deformation of the parts of the body. Look, you can see large defect with irregular form. In this, in center of this defect, skin and the soft tissue is absent because these parts of the skin with soft tissue go into body, into wound canal with bullet. To body, absent exit wound, into wound canal with bullet, you can see skin, soft tissue, and maybe bone tissue in ends of wound canal. This defect named defect minus tissue, because if squeezed edges of this injury, of this wound between fingers, is formed the plates, because in center, skin is absent. This part go with bullet into wound canal. Next, cuneiform action of a bullet. Cuneiform action of a bullet. Kinetic energy over 10 but less 100 joules. And look, my dear friends, into skin you can see small defect, small entrance wound with regular form. In this situation, irregular. Look, irregular form. In this, with cuneiform action, small defect with regular form. Diameter of this defect, repeat diameter of the bullet. If you can see defect with rounded form, shot was under right angle. If you can see entrance wound with oval form, shot was under acute angle. And look, a round of entrance wound in case with cuneiform action of a bullet is formed the abrasion zone. Look, trauma of epidermis. And this zone located under dot zone, zone with dark blackish color. This deposit of soot and drops of oils. So next, look, ages of gunshot injury in case with cuneiform action go into wound canal, inside, into body. Contusion action of a bullet, the kinetic energy less 10 joules. You can see superficial injury, bullet penetrate only into skin and maybe external lamina of a skull bone. Next, the bullet located muscle tissue under skin and maybe is formed abrasions. Abrasion is superficial injury, only epidermis and the papilla layer of dermis. Simple injury. And then, my dear friends, if take forensic medical diagnosis and the clinical diagnosis in a case with gunshot injury, you as a doctor must write in basic trauma, and the forensic medical write in basic trauma, type of gunshot injury, non-perforating gunshot injury. Why is this injury, first injury, named non-perforating? Because into skin present only one defect, entrance wound. Into body present wound canal. And into body located bullet. Exit defect is absent. As a result, this injury named non-perforating and penetrating into body. I repeat, non-perforating. Present only one defect into skin, entrance wound. Into body present wound canal. In answer wound canal located bullet. Bullet may be located in soft tissue, in lung, in inner organs, in cavity, abdominal, thorax cavity. But exit wound is absent. If present exit wound and the bullet go outside, this trauma name perforating and penetrating into body. Perforating, present two defects into skin, place entrance and the place exit. Entrance wound, exit wound. Between located wound canal and the bullet go outside. Next, final tangential wound. Look, you can see in this situation only superficial injury as a wound, as a abrasions. But bullet in this situation have different force, different kinetic energy, as a small, as a large. So, tangential wound. Look, with line form, spindle shape form, and the look result tangential action of a bullet, this abrasion with line form. Next, my dear friends, if take perforating gunshot injury, if into body present two, into skin present two defects. So how determine where located exit, where located entry? In case with entrance wound, present next specific signs. My dear friends, look. Defect minus tissue. Defect minus tissue. Defect minus tissue. Which present in case with explosive and the penetrative action. Next. Dot zone and abrasion zone. Remember, cuneiform action of a bullet. Abrasion zone, locate under dot zone. Cuneiform action of a bullet. Next, stance mark or punch imprint, surface of firearm. You can see this imprint only in case with contact shot. Contact shot. Next, entrance wound have form as a star with laceration, lacerations, few lacerations. This form is formed due to action as a bullet and the powder gases. This contact shot and the close shot first zone. And accompanying components of a shot. Locate as into wound canal and around of entrance wound on surface of the skin in case with contact shot and the close shot. So I repeat, specific signs of entrance wound. The signs present only an entrance in place with entrance wound. Defect minus tissue, dot zone, abrasion zone, edges go inside into wound canal, stance mark, a star-shaped form, a components of a shot. So look next slide, my dear friends. Mechanism, formation, entrance wound and exit wound in case with cuneiform action of a bullet. Kinetic energy between 10 to 100 joules. Look, bullet go into body inside. And with bullet inside goes skin. Look, skin. And in this place is formed hermetic contact skin, edges of entrance wound with the face of a bullet. Due to this contact, into epidermis is formed abrasion. Abrasion zone. Look, in this zone, epidermis is absent. Because in this place, skin have hermetic contact with the face of a bullet. Next, you can see entrance wound with regular rounded form because shot was under right angle. And the diameter of entrance wound repeat diameter of the bullet. Next, bullet go outside, perforating gunshot injury. Look. Ages of exit wound go outside with bullet. In entrance, go inside. Exit, go outside. Irregular form of wound without dot color, abrasion color, accompanying components of a shot. Next, Stanzmark. Stanzmark, my dear friends, Stanzmark. Look, stance mark this imprint. If take forensic traumatology, stance mark name abrasion. This trauma of epidermis, which is formed due to hermetic contact, surface of barrel with epidermis, with skin. In case with a complete contact shot, hermetic contact shot, is formed a stance mark with a regular form, around of entrance wound. If take a lateral contact shot, look, in this situation, shot was under acute angle. In this situation, look, you can see stance mark with semi-lunar form. Semi-lunar form. I repeat, stance mark is abrasion, which is formed due to hermetic contact, firearm, barrel firearm with skin with epidermis. can be rounded form, like a round of entrance wound after a short under right angle, or semi-lunar form in case with, if a short was under acute angle. This specific sign of entrance wound. In place with exit wound, the sign is absent. And look, my dear friends, if take contact short, all accompanying components of a shot go inside into wound canal with bullet, like it into wound canal, wound canal. Next, star-shaped form of entrance wound. This form is formed due to action as a bullet and the powder gases. Powder gases have three types of mechanism action. This mechanical action, you can see lacerations around the entrance wound. Next, chemical action. Look, skin have and the muscle tissue have acute red color due to chemical reaction into skin and into muscle tissue is formed hemoglobin and myoglobin. Carbonic, да, or cap, наверное, cap hemoglobin and cap myoglobin. And the powder gases and the other accompanying components of a shot have very, very large temperature, more than 100 degree, 1000 degree, sorry, 1000 degree. As a result, you can see a sign of burns into soft tissue and skin. Next, specific sign for entrance wound. Look, you can see tattoo sign. This accompanying components of a shot, which accumulation on the surface of the skin around of entrance wound. Because in this situation, shot was closed distance. In case with contact shot, all components go with bullet into wound canal and like it into wound canal. In case with close shot, distance of close shot, you can see tattoo sign around of entrance wound. Look, in this case, you can see result of cuneiform action of a bullet. Because entrance wound with regular rounded form, small size, in this place present abrasion zone, edges go inside into wound canal, and the diameter of this injury, repeat diameter of the bullet, and the look, in this situation, you can see defect minus tissue, but without deformation of the hand. As a result, this penetrative action of a bullet with defect minus tissue. This deposit of soot, the substance with a black color, which is formed due to burns of gunpowder at shot. These tattoo signs in this situation, gunpowder, small metallic particles penetrate into skin. This sign name, tattoo sign. Distance of shot, my dear friends, as in Ukraine, as in your country, distinguished three distance of shot. General name, contact shot, close shot, distance shot. In case with contact shot, my dear friends, look, accompanying components of a shot go inside into wound canal with bullet. And around of entrance wound, you can see Stanz mark or semi-lunar form or rounded form. But all accompanying components of a shot go into wound canal. Contact shot can be complete or hermetic, incomplete, between skin and the firearm present very small distance, 0.5 centimeters, 5 millimeters. and the lateral short under acute angle. Next, if take close short, if take close short, you can see a components of a short on surface of the skin around and transwound tattoo sign, deposit of soot, gunpowder, small metallic particles, drops of oils, nicate into skin on surface of the skin around of entrance wound in case with close shot. If take distance shot, a component is absent. You can see action only bullet. So my dear friends, please re-enter in Zoom because I have only one. No, so good. So, my dear friends, continue. I repeat, in forensic traumatology, distinguish three distance of a shot. This contact shot, close shot, and distance shot. Contact shot, all the components locate into wound canal, into body. In case with close shot, all the components locate on the skin around of entrance wound. And in case with distance shot, this very, very large distance. As a result, you can see action only bullet. Mechanical injury, gunshot injury is formed in only due to action of a bullet without a components of a shot. Next, look specific position, a hand with pistols in case with suicide. And look, you can see sign of acute death, cyanosis. Look, that's very quickly coming. And look, in this situation, you can see explosive action of a bullet. Look, on anterior surface of the neck present entrance wound, and look, destroyed, you can see destroyed of a head with destroyed of a soft bone tissue and brain, this explosive action, kinetic energy over 1,000 joules. And that's very quickly coming due to basic trauma, due to perforating gunshot injury of the head with damage on the brain. And look, you can see urinary excretion as a sign of acute death. Next, listen to me, my dear friends, attention please. Because this information are difficult for students, for understand for students, and this information present in our situational task, which I will ask you tomorrow. Defect entrance specific sign, defect entrance defect and exit defect into bone. Now, for example, take defect into skull bone. Remember, skull bone, this flat, spongy bone. In skull bone, distinguish outer lamina, external lamina, inner lamina, internal lamina, between like spongy substance. So if take entrance defect, because wound, remember traumatology, wound this trauma of the skin into bone present defect. Entrance defect into skull bone. Look, in outer lamina, external lamina, you can see small defect with regular rounded or oval form. Diameter this defect, repeat diameter of bullet with regular edges. In inner lamina, internal lamina, is formed large defect with irregular form. And listen to me, bone fragments, protrude into cranial cavity, locate into wound canal, bone fragments. Next, exit defect, change situation. Inner lamina, internal lamina, small defect with regular form diameter, repeat diameter of a bullet. External lamina, large defect with irregular form, and the bone fragments of spongy substance and external lamina go outside with bullet. So, repeat. Entrance defect, inner, into external lamina, outer lamina, small defect, regular form. Inner lamina, large defect with irregular form. Bone fragments protrude into cranial cavity, into wound canal. Exit defect, internal lamina, small, regular form defect. External lamina, large with irregular form. Bone fragments go outside with bullet. So look, you can see external lamina, small defect with regular edges, regular form. Internal lamina, inner lamina, large defect with irregular form. As a result, this entrance defect. Change situation. Inner lamina, regular form defect with regular edges. External lamina and spongy substance present large defects with irregular form. As a result, this exit defect into skull bone. Next, my dear friends, you can see 1, 2, 3 entrance wound into skin. So this wound is formed first, this second, this third. Why? All bleeding more massive bleeding, because in this situation bleeding blood go out under arterial pressure. Next, due to third gunshot injury, arterial pressure in blood vessels decreased. As a result, if take second gunshot injury, bleeding moderate. So if take next, continue, arterial pressure continue decrease, continue go down, more go down. And in case with third gunshot injury, bleeding is absent. Next, look, first, second. Why? Because due to first gunshot injury, this man changed position of the body. And look, bleeding second, bleeding like it under angle at first bleeding. Look, due to change position, and bleeding change direction, like it under angle at first bleeding. Next, if take two gunshot injuries and if take one firearm. In first gunshot injury, in dot zone, dot color, you can see more oils. Second gunshot injury, in dot zone, you can see more soot, small oils. If take one firearm and two shots. In first dot zone, present many oils. In second, in dot zone, present many soot. Next. If take two gunshot injuries into one lung, left or right, due to first gunshot injury, into thorax cavity is formed the pneumothorax, and the lung change size. Due to first gunshot injury, after first gunshot injury, lung have small size. As a result, entrance wound into lung change place. Look, entrance wound into skin, like it in this zone. Entrance wound into lung due to change size, like it in this place. And into lung, you can see indirect wound canal. Second gunshot injury have direct wound canal because it's formed after pneumothorax. Next, if take intestine, first gunshot injury with large size, with irregular form. Second, have regular small form diameter, repeat diameter of a buoy. So, my dear friends, our topic